Brayden Point scored the fastest hat trick in NHL history last night. 91 seconds.
Sixth fastest hat trick.
Excuse me, sixth fastest. 91 seconds, all three goals coming on the power play.
Not bad. That's a pretty good minute and a half, if you don't mind. Don't mind if I do. Barely even break a sweat. They're all on the power play, all different kind of goals. But Brayden Point reasserting how important he is to Tampa. He might be coming up on their most important forward. As important as Kucherov, as Stamkos, and you look at some of the, oh, my old Liney Kinger in there, 78 seconds. He didn't tell me that. And yeah. Bill Moisienko, 21 seconds.
21 seconds
there
is amazing.
Has to be,
I don't even understand how that's possible.
There has to be empty netters. There has to be. And empty netters mixed in there.
We will find that out.
I didn't call that game. That is,
that is solid. Yes. And the other thing I always wondered about the hat tricks, because I never got one in the regular season, embarrassingly enough.
I'm surprised.
How, like, the three pucks they're holding after the game, they're not the three pucks they scored with. They just, I'm sort of burst their bubble. Like, they don't grab a puck every time you get your first one.
That's right. That's right.
You didn't grab every puck you score. Oh, I got two. Let's grab that one.
In 21 seconds, it might have been the same puck.
Why has he got three of them?
But it might have been one puck.
So everyone's after the thing, like, here I am, my four pucks.
Yeah.
Nope. They're not the same four pucks.
Wow. Yeah.
It's always your
mind blown.
Burst in bubbles.
Mind blown, Jackie.
Yeah. And actually, my mind is blown right now because I've never thought about that logically.
He thinks about that.
Well, he's very logical, Mike Johnson.
He is.
That's why.
Yes, he is.
Or it's just something I never had to deal with because I never got one. Unbelievable.
I'm sorry. Well, you were good enough. You could have got one.
Well,
passed on empty netters all the time with two goals.
Well, you know what?
Bad idea.
So, yeah,
since you never got one, why don't you take us through this one?
Yes, please do.
I can tell you about other guys who had theirs.
Please do. Brayden Point, good at it. You're good at it.
Five on three here.
Five on three here. So what I liked about Brayden Point, all three goals in the power play, but all from different locations. So this is a bit of a broken play late in the period. He takes a puck off the half wall, and he elects to shoot from about 25 feet, and what a shot it was. Just a gorgeous over-the-shoulder of Matt Murray. So that's goal number one, off the half wall. Now, another five on three. Wait a second, he's not off the half wall anymore. They run a little rotation. He's down on the goal line now. His first goal, shot one, just below the face-off line. Now he's on the goal line extended, and what a beautiful pass this is by Steve Stamkos. Everyone bites on the shot fake, but Brayden Point, as versatile as he is, can be in a completely different spot in the same situation and be dangerous. So now it's a five on four, same power play again. He's right in the middle of the 1-3-1. He's not over on the other side where he took shots one and two. He's right in the center of the box as the trigger man, a little pop play, and another really good finish. Elevates it over top of the pad, might not even have had to, but he's still there. And it just reinforces how versatile he can be in every situation, in offensive situations, different spots on the ice. And to score three goals in 91 seconds all in the power play, and not one of them being similar to the other, even more impressive.
Yeah, the Tampa Bay Lightning have a great power play, and they have some really high-end players that can make it happen, and Point is certainly one of them. I will say, I wasn't overly impressed with the Penguins' penalty killing. It was very, very passive in that circumstance.
Tough to be aggressive five-on-threes.
Yeah, the five-on-three will give you a break, but there was the five-on-four there, too, just very passive. Well, but give them credit. But they have a lot of guys. They
pick your poison.
They can kill you.
You're gonna protect at the top because you have Steve Stamkos and Kucherov,
right,
which opens up, slot play.
Exactly.
That's the point. Like, you gotta give them something.